back off another close victory, a nail biter against another conference opponent, a conference rival now, you could say, since they're becoming successful now, North Texas. And we in here, and we finally done made it back up to number two in the nation. Let's get it. After taking the loss that we lost and building ourselves back up, we back up to number two. We got two more recruits committed. We got Savage, a four-star tight end, and Browning, a three-star wide receiver, committed. We got some other commits climbing up the board, but we in good spirits right now because we got to – if y'all saw the last episode, that was a crazy game. That was a wild game, and again, it was a game that in the beginning I said we can't shortchange our opponents, but I felt like we should have a convincing victory over them, and it ended up going down to the wire. We almost blew it. We had the ball with a chance to seal it. All we had to do was run the timeout, and I was trying to get cute and add extra points, and they picked it off, took it to the house, took the lead, and we had to scratch and claw back. So it was a crazy game. Paris Meek, 7 catches, 283 yards, 4 touchdowns. You seen Cam Hardy, you know, all these players had big games. They stepped up. And that led us to where we're at right now, being back to number two in the nation. And just as I predicted last episode, the conference championship is a rematch, and we're going up against North Texas again. So we're going to have to be on our P's and Q's because they almost beat us that game. You know, final score 51-49 off a clutch field goal at the end, but not just a clutch field goal. A clutch field goal that was blocked and returned for a touchdown that got called back because of running into the kicker. So that was a crazy game. But you see it. Paris Meeks had a huge week. The team has turned it around after that loss that we shouldn't have lost. And, you know, we got some recruits we gotta highlight, we got to bring back in. We got to analyze everything because right now we're on a bye week and we just trying to get by. We're doing everything we can just to get by, you know, like Talib Kweli would say. So, we're looking at everything. We're looking at the top classes so far, and so far we're nowhere in there. But I think part of the reason for that is because I haven't really been bringing in a lot of prospects. Like, I got a few prospects to commit, some of them some four-star athletes, as you see, some two-star athletes as well, but it's not a lot. We only got six. I only brought in six this whole entire time because I've been keeping my board so short, and I just a couple weeks ago added more prospects, more targets to my board. But again, just because I told y'all a couple episodes ago that once you get your team built to where you want to have them built at, you want to keep the prospects you bring in yearly between 15 to 17, 15 to 20. That's the sweet spot because you don't want to find yourself in a position where you have to cut players you don't want to cut. But just because I mentioned that don't mean go do what I just did right now and only have six prospects committed at this point in time in the season. No, you want to be further along than that. But that's partly my mistake for keeping the board so small and not really going too hard after certain players. You know, like, I got some committed, but and I got some who I'm in their top, but that doesn't mean anything. Like, you want to get more players committed before this point. Like, we're going in conference championship weekend. We only got six players or six prospects committed. That's not cool. So keep in mind, although your team is already built, you still want to have anywhere between 15 to 17 players that you bring in yearly. So now that doesn't mean I'm only going to have six prospects that's coming in this year. Like, I still got the rest of this season. Well, I think we're coming up on that time where they're about to stop letting me actually recruit prospects. But even with that, once the off season comes, I'll still have that window where I could finish recruiting before then. So I'll at the least bare minimum have like anywhere between 10 to 12 prospects committed by the time the next season starts, which for somebody like me, that won't hurt because I overdid it with my first two seasons, bringing in so many prospects. So if I were to bring in so few at this point, then cool. That would work out fine because I'm probably still going to have players that need to be cut because of what I did the first two seasons. But it's all good. We're going to roll with it. You know, we got 45 hours left. We started out with about 215 or so. 215, 220. I can't remember what my starting point was. Been talking too much. But y'all see it. So I think we got this week left. And then once we advance, we go to the next week. We'll have some more hours. But if I'm not mistaken, after conference championship week, I don't think you can recruit anymore. I don't know. We'll find out. We'll find out. But as far as conference standings, we're standing alone at the top at number one after we fell off. And then we're back at number two. And Texas is number one. Texas Tech, I mean, is number one at 11-1. So, yeah, it's time to get it. We're going to go ahead and advance, roll to the next week. And I'm going to keep rolling in. Normally, I cut it, but I'm going to keep rolling in. And, okay, there we go. We got ourselves another four-star. Brian Cush is actually one of the guys that I really wanted because if I'm not mistaken, I think his speed was like a 96, 97, something like that. Something crazy. We still number two. That's a plus. Nobody knocked off Texas Tech, so it's all love. But Texas Tech probably had a bye like us. As you can see, we got three players, this three-star recruits, that have us number one on their board. So, again, we started off a little rough, but we got some people that's moving us up. We got another guard. Right guard Phoenix, who's got us number three on his board. He has us first on his board. Alfonso has us number three on his board. Ezekiel, whatever his name is, has us number two. So, but you see it. So just because we had six up until that point committed, don't mean that that's going to be all that we get. So we got ourselves another one that's seven, and we got four more actually that has us first. And it's looking pretty solid. We got Oregon versus Iowa matchup this week. So we got, what was that? I think it was LSU and Arkansas. But contract extended. So we got extended. You can see the turnaround we've made. This is Florida Atlantic before even Blackman got the coaching position. So this is what you see. And you can see the turnaround right there. Those are our 3 years so far. First year, 12-3. Lost in the second round of the college football playoff. Second year, 16-0, national champs. And third year, we're 11-1, about to go in conference championship week. And the rest is to be told. The rest is to be told. So you see it. Coach Blackman should get coach of the year again. Probably won't because we're not undefeated. But we're going to see. We're going to see how much that matters or not. But hell of a start to his coaching career. You know, comes out, picks up Florida Atlantic, doesn't really have that many really good seasons like say so, and comes in and completely turns them around and turns them into a powerhouse. So we back at recruiting with 90 recruiting hours left. We want to get ourselves a kicker in here. None of these kickers have us like anywhere on their radar right now. I think it's, yeah, two of them. Yeah, we need to get ourselves some kicker help because our kicker isn't going to be there forever. The kicker is kind of the one that I push to the back end because it's like whatever. I don't really plan on kicking anyways. And especially in this game, I try to avoid those situations and circumstances at all costs because it's really those wide hashes. I've gotten used to the actual kick meter, but it's the getting used to the wide hashes after playing Madden all these years. And, yeah, so I try to avoid it. So it's not necessarily like I have to have the best kicker in the nation. I just got to have a body pretty much. But we're going to see how that goes. Let's see, Honeycutt. Did I recruit him all the way? I don't think I did. Let's see what Wiley got. Right tackle. What's his strength at? Strength 81. Eh. He's a gem, but I'm not big on the strength part. When I got offensive linemen, I gotta have like somebody with like at least 86, 87 strength. But it's doable. He's a gem, so we're gonna allocate some hours towards him and see where we go from there. So that's about it of our hours this week. But we're gonna go ahead and cut it short. And again, if y'all here for the first time or you're returning and you haven't liked or subscribed already, please do so. Click that notification tab so you can stay up to speed on all of this Florida Atlantic Dynasty rebuild, as well as other College Football 25 content, whether it be tutorials, updates, College Football 26 leaks, etc. We'll have it for you here. So, again, I appreciate you all for tuning in. That's been my time. Till next time.